increase the offtake of fertilizers by reducing the price a little bit.
Certainly.
So therefore, I would welcome that kind of a measure. But your point regarding the efficiency of public enterprises versus subsidies, certainly increase in efficiency is the best solution from the long-term point of view. But from the point of view of farmers, subsidy on fertilizer imports as opposed to subsidy on food, I would think the food subsidy directly goes to the benefit of it goes to the consumers, the poorer consumers. Therefore, I would be in favor of continuance of food subsidies.
So given a resource crunch, you would rather not reduce food subsidies, but
yes,
go in for cutting out the subsidies given to inefficient public sector farmers.
Exactly.
Thank you. Pranay, I think you can take on from there.
Yeah, I just wanted to actually, there is a budget flash here. I think obviously the finance minister has almost been teasing Tarun Das here, because he's just announced something which may welcome you on cars. Components for fuel efficient cars up to 1000 cc's reduced by 15% for 2 years. That means Maruti's will actually be cheaper if this is passed on. And but on the other hand, excise duties on air conditioners up to 7.5 tons. That's the smaller air conditioners revised upwards. Therefore, small air conditioners are going to cost a little more. Vimal, am I right in saying that components for fuel efficient cars, that's the Maruti, that means up to 1000
cc? No, I think that applies to everybody.
Everybody.
If I, this is for the ancillary manufacturers.
I mean, the idea
is that those who are subject to the...
So this 15% reduction...
Yes, I mean that is my recollection.
Reduced to 15%.
I don't have paper in front of me, but that is my recollection that it is...
It's across the board.
Yes,
so that may not be only for Maruti.
Ancillary manufacturers.
Then would you welcome that?
Yes, we've been seeking a duty cut on automotive components. But that doesn't do away with the increase in the duty on cars.
Can't have everything.
Well, I think we must have an automotive industry which is strong.
No, it is.
And I think the policy framework must give an environment for growth.
No, but Tarun, I think that if you see the whole thing, I mean, you would appreciate that it's a
strong the whole thing. We're waiting for
the whole thing actually is summarized in one thing which everybody seemed to want to talk about. That was the deficit for this year. Can we have a quick comment on that, Manu?
Well, what I would say is that Dr. Hanumant Rao said that it depends on next year's national income. If there is no drought and if there is good monsoon and so on, income will go up and therefore deficit as a percentage of that will be small, but it will not be. A very quick calculation shows that even if money incomes go up by 15% next year, which means a real growth of 5%, price increase of 10%,
I'll have to interrupt you.
It will be 2.5%.
I'm sorry, they've got the finance minister finally. I don't know.
Is it okay? Mr. Tiwari, non-plan expenditure has increased to over 48,000 crores. How do you think you're going to be able to contain the deficit?
Well, you might have seen that even this year, we have been able to contain the deficit to the level announced last year by the Prime Minister. You know, it's just near the level that was. So this year also, we hope that we will be able to, with the cooperation of all concerned, we will be able to contain non-plan expenditure. I have in my speech mentioned some of the imperative necessities because of which, for example, say, defense or fertilizer subsidies or food subsidies. On the one hand, we had to pay higher agricultural prices. On the other, we had to subsidize the public distribution system. So this led to more subsidies. And similarly, we had to undertake massive programs to fight drought and floods.
Inflation is already running at about 10%. With the level of deficit and the increase in non-plan expenditure, what do you think is the likely situation next year?
Well, this inflation is not man-made. It is nature-made. If there would have been no drought, if there have been, on the one hand, we all admit that there has been an unprecedented drought in the country. So it certainly led to the fall of agricultural production, fall in power generation. It had all these after effects. It is because of this that we see this situation. But compared to what it was in 79, when the inflation rose up to the 21%, I think we owe it to all people and everybody concerned that we have only reached this 9.8% inflation, the wholesale price index reflecting this level.
Mr. Tiwari, every year...
My budget, by inducing more production in agriculture and industry, I think you have to go through the budget speech in the budget literature. This is production oriented, this is growth oriented, employment oriented for all sectors of economy, agriculture, housing, industry, small industry, village industry. So this will lead, this is also anti-inflation budget. This is anti-inflation budget.
Mr. Tiwari, every year administered prices of a series of items go up before the budget. Do you think this denigrates the budgetary process? And do you think this is, you know, because the states don't get a share of this?
Well, I think if you look at the full picture, then you will understand the complicated situation. For example, if we have these wage rises, you have to provide for new increased dearness allowance, you have to provide for interim relief and all that, then it has its effect on prices. Prices, for example, for if steel industry, we pay more wages, which we have to pay, then it certainly it has to, then otherwise the public sector enterprises, it run into huge losses, then that is also criticized. So we are, from point of view of the whole economy, I think we are charting a very difficult course. And therefore, what we are doing is the least harmful for the economy.
But don't you think this denigrates the budgetary process?
I do not think so. Because it is a part, for example, if you say administrative prices for steel, that is a part of the steel budget, of the sale. Sale has to balance its budget. You know, otherwise, it would have gone into losses of 400 crores. So it is what we have done is to is the administered prices are done in a very measured way. It is not.
But the states don't get a share of it.
Well, states get a share in the sense the administered prices. You know, if I do not think in what particular direction you are targeting your question, because there is no question of administered prices being shared by states. These are mainly in the public sector undertakings.
But the petrol hike...
If, for example, if state electricity boards raise their revenues, it goes to the states. So it is not as if...
But the petrol hike, for instance?
Yes. Petrol hike, you are isolating only petrol. But diesel has not been touched. Diesel has not been touched. Other gas has not been touched. Only petrol, in order also to have is other conserve petrol also. It has a conservation measure also.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, I was just trying to listen to the finance minister. Actually, the main point he was trying to get across that this budget was aiming at revitalizing production in the economy, both in the agricultural sector and in the industrial sector, by providing certain boost to demand in the industrial sector by reductions in excise duties across various items. We'll be giving you a set of balance sheets for different sections. Let's have a look first at what it's done, what this budget has done for the farmer. Now, on the left-hand side, there are not very many losses. We may see that on other sectors, in industry and in for the consumer. But the gains for the farmer have been the main items in this budget. Food and fertilizer subsidies are up 20%. Fertilizer prices have been cut down 7.5%. There's a Jaldhari scheme for marginal farmers, which Dr. Bimal Jalan was talking about. Bank finance to the agricultural sector is up. Import and excise duty on pesticides reduced, therefore pesticides to be cheaper. No excise on machinery for horticulture, poultry and beekeeping. These are again agricultural sector. So the basic thrust of this budget has been gains for the farmers. Kirit, do you think that is welcome?
That is certainly true. I had some reservations about increasing the subsidies all along. I think the economic survey suggested that they're going to reduce subsidies and that they're perhaps also restrain increases in government, public sector employees' earnings and so on. These hopes that it had raised have not been borne out. Otherwise, I think the general thrust on agriculture...
Fortunately for the people, budget is not made by economists.
Manu, I'll be asking you something on the consumer side of it because we have a consumer budget, a consumer balance sheet which may not be quite so one-sided gains-wise as the farmers. If we look at the consumer balance sheets, it's as follows. On the loss side, the first loss, the 5% surcharge on taxable income above 50,000 rupees is to continue. They're not dropping it, maybe for 1 year. On the plus side, major excise cuts to benefit housing and bank loans. So excise cuts,
interest cuts,
I think it means they're not excise cuts. On the second loss, tax on transfer of wealth for wealth tax payees, I think that is. That's a form of estate duty again, I think. Two, on the gain side, rate and limit of standard deduction raised. I think the standard deduction has been raised by 2,000 rupees, so that will benefit all taxpayers. On the losses side, point number three, excise on large cars. That's not the Maruti, so those who were rushing to buy the Maruti yesterday haven't gained anything. But large cars, excise duties are up. But vegetable oil, sugar, coffee, tea, kerosene will be cheaper. So large cars, I think in a nutshell, that gives an indication of what the finance minister was trying to do. Essential commodities are cheaper. Inessential commodities, there are hikes. On the fourth point, excise on large color TV sets raised. I think that's more thrust on the same point. Any TV set above 36 centimeters that costs, I think, more than 7,000 rupees or so will cost another 250 rupees more. While items such as jams, jellies, pickles, radios, cassette players, soaps by cooperatives will be cheaper. Fifth, we've run out of losses, so now we're onto the gain side. Handlooms, electronic calculators, utensils and toys are cheaper, and 5% capital issues will be reserved for employees and funded by banks. Yes, I think, sir. I need a major explanation by that. Could you explain that?
Yes, for the workers to buy up to 5% of equity in their companies. I mean, there is already a stock options scheme for workers. The banks will give loans liberally for that purpose. I mean, the operative part here is that the banks
so
will
basically,
give loans liberally.
I think that's a fairly important thing, that workers can now take up to, at least there will be 5% reserved for employees of companies.
In new issues. That has been there so far.
And that will now be financed a lot by banks, I see.
Yes, I mean, okay. that the employees can borrow from the banks to buy the shares in their own companies. I mean, that is a new scheme.
I see.
I mean, that is going to be announced by the Reserve Bank of India.
Manu, overall reaction for the consumer?
Well, I suppose the consumer should welcome some of these changes. Wherever there is an essential item, the finance minister has tried to give concessions. he, of course, needs revenue, so therefore he has to levy a general tax. But I think what is missing in this is concessions for the producer.
No, I think that
we're just coming to we're just coming to actually a couple of things I want to do. One is quickly look into the balance sheet of industry. Talk to Tarun from industry and then go to the stock exchange and then come back to you, Manu, if I can on that. Now, that's the balance sheet for industry. Budget 88 balance sheet, it says on top, losses and gains. Losses, air conditioners to cost more. Actually, the smaller air conditioners, which is probably what will hit most people. On the gain side, excise on cement reduced. On the losses side, special excise duty on basic excise duty levy. That 1/20th of whatever excise you're paying now will be a surcharge on that. It will amount to another 1% excise, but that does not apply to a number of essential items. Excise on aluminium foil, cold storage components and drugs is lower altogether. That's a gain for industry. Excise on computer software is down. I think that's custom duty on computer software, down from 15% to 10%. We saw that flashed across the screen. Customs duty on food and packed items is down. Customs duty on energy savings items has been completely abolished. So that may not be an overall complete list, but that's the main point so far.
I just want
to go to Tarun.
No, but may I just say one thing, which is quite important. I think that is not really the whole main thing. I mean, in the sense that there is a very major package, for example, for textiles.
Which we haven't got at all.
Electronics, there is another very
one thing, there is, we do only hear the budget speech, and there are 170 paragraphs, and we have 170 minutes.
I know. You've done a marvelous job, but I thought that in fairness.
Tarun, can I just ask you an overall assessment for industry of this budget?
I don't see a new environment for industry in this.
I think you will when you read it.
Bimal is saying that we will have to study the papers. Actually, normally when we study the papers, we find the fine print is more worrying than what we have got now. So we were looking for a new environment for industry. We were looking for fiscal instruments and psychological impact of the budget. Whatever we've heard over the last 2 hours, we haven't seen that. I'm sorry to sound a little negative.
No, but what we're going to do is just before we all, we'll come for a summing up so each panelist and experts can actually give a summing up of the budget. But before that, the stock exchange reaction is very important. Let me go over to Bombay.
Welcome back to Bombay, viewers. The news here is that the trading activity has concluded, and it appears that the initial downward trend was arrested, and the stock exchange has picked up slightly. However, the figures are 411.22. This is the Bombay Sensitive Index. This is the position at the morning session, and it has concluded at about 406.02 at the moment, which means there has been a decline of five points. And we can make it 1 percentage point. The figures for market leaders like Tata Steel also bear the same trend. Tata Steel began at 576.25 on the 25th. It was about 591.25 in the morning and has concluded at 595 today. So there hasn't been any perceptible difference in the price of Tata Steel. Would you, Mr. Kambani, like to comment on the situation?
See, actually there is a mixed reaction on the market, and then probably, see, the market has recovered a little bit, probably on a covering of the shares and the purchase from the financial institution, and the market has come up. But it may not continue to that extent.
What do you expect as far as the trend is concerned? Do you expect it to decline or to go up?
I feel that in a short run, the market probably may decline. Of course, there are a lot of redeeming features for the budget and for the economy. So unless until those forces will not come to play, the market will not go up. See, immediately the reaction for the investors was to expect such a concessions so that the investor psychology improves, which I feel the budget could not able to really enthuse the investors. That is what my worry is there. But I am not bearish for the long term. But I am really bearish for the short term.
Do you agree with Mr. Kambani's views, sir?
Well, it is basically a growth-oriented budget. The finance minister had a Herculean job, which he has done miraculously well, I must say. The initial reaction of the market was a bit bearish, with our index sliding down from 411 to 395. On a better appraisal of the various proposals made by the finance minister, the market reacted favorably. And the index currently is in the region of 406. Well, when the market reopens again tomorrow, after a proper assessment, I personally feel the market might look up. Well, the market...
Well, let's have a quick summing up of... We've got about another 5 or 6 minutes. A quick summing up all around the table. Before we go to the Reserve Bank governor, which we'd like to go next, let's have a look at what the budget deficit has to say and what will affect him next year a lot. We know that in 87-88, the budget deficit, the Prime Minister said, was 5,688. That was exceeded by 392 crores, actually a very small increase to 6,080. And the budget deficit this year is targeted at 7,484 crores. That is lower than year before last. So that is also a conservative kind of approach to deficit financing. Let's see whether that makes the RBI governor happy. Subhashish.
Thank you, Pranay. Mr. Malhotra, I would like you to react to this question that Pranay has asked you. Very simply, do you think that your bank will be able to maintain prices, will be able to carry out the good things, so-called good things that the budget is hoping for?
Well, personally, I think that so far as the current year's ultimate budget deficit expectation is a matter of some satisfaction, because there were major problems arising out of the drought and in the defense area. And that the latest expectation is that it is going to be very close to what was put in the budget estimate is a matter of great satisfaction. Insofar as the next year's budget is concerned, I think much would depend on the rate of growth of the economy next year. Well, it does pose a challenge, actually, in the monetary area, because one would have to see what its impact on the money supply situation would be. And to my mind, the signal, insofar as the budget deficit is concerned, is that while every effort should be made to provide for credit to for growth, the stance of policy would have to be very cautionary.
Thank you. Mr. Professor Rao, I would like to ask you one very simple question. It seems that there is a general feeling, part of the panel in Pranay's part feels that there has been a boost for consumers. You are going to increase demand through these excise duty reductions, barring that 1/20th percent that complication. And some feel that there has not been enough boost to producers or on the supply side. And Mr. Tarun Das in particular thinks that there is nothing to be happy about, there is no change in the environment for industry. What do you think?
Yes, for industrial development now, in the next year particularly, what is the need of the hour? To my mind, the greatest need is to revive the demand. Otherwise, there will be recession and industry will be worst affected by recession. I think therefore the budget rightly directs itself to this question of reviving the demand for industry, both by reducing some of the excise duties for essential commodities for raising the demand, as well as by stepping up plan outlay, particularly for agriculture, in order to raise the agricultural output. So it tries to tackle the problem of revival through the revival of demand. So I think this is in the right direction.
But thank you, Professor. I think we are running out of time, so I'll go back to Pranay to see what he has to say.
I'm told we are waiting for a quick reaction from trade union leaders in Madras, so if we can go straight across to Madras for their views on the budget.
Mr. Pillai, what is your reaction to the claim that 94% of the planned outlay has been met?
My reaction is that it doesn't say categorically how those resources are going to be raised. My impression is that as in the past, they allow public sector to go into the market and borrow. But the resource crunch as far as generating resources for the public sector, that is not being tackled. In my opinion, the two basic issues facing the country have not been faced in any clear fashion. There has been, during the last 3 years, a mounting deficit in foreign trade, which in the last 3 years has amounted to something like 25,000 crores. The internal debt is increasing, as is shown by the fact that interest charges are rising. Many goodies have been thrown around, which may confuse the issue as to whether you are tackling the basic problems of the economy or not. The question as to whether the public sector will be administered in such a way that resources will be generated, that is not answered at all. There are a number of industries where employment potential is going down. What answer I could see no answer in the budget as to whether those particular industries will be revived or given adequate resources to provide.
Right, that's a quick reaction from the budget, and now we'll get a final summing up in the last 5 minutes from our panel. If we can start from left to right, I don't know if that's the political views as well, but let's assume not. Tarun, can we have a quick overall summing? You've had a lot of goodies and still you're negative. What's your overall view, not only from the industrial point of view, but from the economy as a whole?
I think the goodies are for agriculture and the common man. Very welcome, many of them innovative. Good, absolutely positive on that. Housing, there seems to have been a package. Worry area, National Housing Bank announced last year in the budget. We still haven't seen that on the ground. Government expenditure increases planned. Worry area because of major overruns on government expenditure. And I like the Prime Minister's reference to controlling government expenditure and productivity. On industry, I don't see a freedom run for industry yet. I don't see a climate for growth. We'll have to see the fine print.
Kirit, a quick summing up because we've got two more waiting and there are 3 minutes left.
I think it's a growth-oriented budget, right? But I still remain concerned about the projected deficit, and I'm not sure that even though it may the bureaucrats may be happy, economists who think a little longer term perspective might feel that next year you may not be able to curtail the deficit because you won't have another chance to increase administered prices.
Yes.
And so on and so forth.
But did
so
you say, do you think the deficit is too low or too high?
I think it's too high. I think it should have been smaller. I think in a longer term perspective, as Governor Malhotra had pointed out, you cannot have ever increasing public deficit. Unless the economy is growing even at a fast rate.
Yes. Manu?
I think it's on the whole a constructive budget. A lot of effort has been made to satisfy various sections of society, particularly agriculture, but also consumers of various kinds. Some duty concessions for some industries will help, but the effort is not sufficient in terms of growth orientation in industry. I am also worried about the continued high deficit. It works out, I just made a calculation, about 2.5% of next year's national income. In my view, it could have been reduced by two ways. Non-plan expenditure could have been cut further by 5%, you would have got about 2,000 crores. If public sector enterprises produce profits, economic survey says 12%, but if you take out the oil sector, it comes to less than 1%. In fact, it is negative if you make a proper calculation. That could have given you another 1,000, 1,500 crores. Why this deficit year after year?
Right. And Bimal, a quick summary from you of what the overall objective of the budget was and whether you think it's achieved its aims.
But I don't want to react to the other panelists.
Your own.
Let me.
Yes.
And I would like to make a couple of points first in regard to that. What you have here is really a sample, I mean, not the whole thing. And from what I gather from the panelists' view, the sample tastes all right. The appetizer, the first dish that you have got is excellent, I think. So I don't have any complaints about whatever they have said, but I would just urge your viewers as well as everybody else around town to wait for the whole thing to come out, because the constraints under which you are working, they are really tremendous, but you've done a fine job in a very exciting presentation today. I think what the finance minister has tried to do, and having been in some small way been associated with it, I am a partial observer, I should say so. But agriculture, I mean, the major thing, that's the need of the hour. Housing, particularly rural housing, another need of the hour. I mean, all of us would agree that that's the thrust area and must do something. Creates construction, creates jobs. I mean, that is another important thing. Social security. I think you would find probably when you read the budget that a very major thing has been done in establishing the institutional foundation of a wide-ranging system of social security for the weaker sections. Then you have for the scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, and all India new corporation. For certain other sectors, like weavers, for example, handloom weavers, a higher rebate. In industry, you know, we didn't have the time to get in, but agro-based industries, textiles, capital goods, cement. I mean, there are obviously, every budget has some minus points, and we will, you know, can argue about it later. But thank you very much. I don't want to say any more.
Apparently, we're running a little over time, so we've tried to give you, in a capsule, one of the longest budget speeches in history. But let's hope we've gone some of the way to what you'll read in tomorrow's papers. Thank you very much for being with us. I'm going to go to the next slide.